Let's analyze the data that came from crossing two yellow mice. The first step, data entry. The authors of the study identified 800 yellow mice and 435 not yellow offspring in the cross between two yellow mice. So in sum, follow along in the equation bar here. That produced 1,235 total offspring. Now we need to determine how many offspring of those two phenotypes, yellow and not yellow, we would have expected if there was a 3-to-1 ratio of yellow to not yellow, which would be 75% yellow and 25% not yellow. So 75% of 1,235, 25%. And those are the predictions that Mendel would have if the two yellow mice being crossed are heterozygotes. And then we've also got a second hypothesis or prediction that we might see a 2-to-1 ratio of yellow to not yellow. And as always, for the chi-square test, which we're about to perform to see if the observed values are significantly different from either of the expected values, we don't round these numbers, even though it doesn't make biological sense to have 926 and a quarter yellow mice. The important point is that the two expected values have to add up exactly to the same total number of mice that were observed in the initial experiment. So now we need to do the last calculation. We've got the observed values. We've got two different sets of expected values. So we need to calculate the chi-square test statistic value, comparing the observation to the expectation of these two different hypotheses, the 3-to-1 ratio and the 2-to-1 ratio. And we're going to find out whether or not the observed data better fit the 3-to-1 or the 2-to-1 observation or expectation. So in this case, the chi-square calculation is the observed value minus the expected value squared divided by the expected value for both phenotypes, yellow in this case, and then we add the same calculation for the other phenotypic category, not yellow. And we do the same calculation for the other hypothesis. And finally, we need to identify the p-value associated with these two chi-square test statistic values. We can do that with the chi-dist function, where we select the test statistic value and then the number of degrees of freedom, which is the number of categories, in this case phenotypes. We have two phenotypes, yellow and not yellow, minus one. Two categories minus one equals one degree of freedom. And here we see that there's a highly statistically significant difference, a p-value less than 0.05. In this case, this is a 1 times 10 to the minus 16th. Or a 0.0, 15 zeros, and then a 1 p-value much, much, much smaller than 0.05, that tells us that there's a highly statistically significant difference between seeing 926.25 expected if there's a 3-to-1 ratio compared to 800, and 300 not yellow expected when we see many more in reality. Ultimately, the ratio of observed mice, yellow to not yellow, was 1.84 to 1. So the p-values tell us that 2-to-1, p-value of 0.159, is not significantly different from 1.84 to 1. 2-to-1, almost 2-to-1. But this observed data, 800 yellow to 435 not yellow, is very significantly different than a 3-to-1 ratio. We should have seen 126 more yellow mice and the same number fewer not yellow mice if this phenotype is segregating in a 3-to-1 phenotypic fashion. So these were the data that suggested that something weird is going on with the segregation of the yellow phenotype. It's not meeting Mendelian expectations. It's not a 3-to-1 phenotype ratio. It seems to be very much like a 2-to-1 phenotypic ratio.